Hi, I'm Victoria Godso, an AI Developer Enablement Manager from AMD, and today I'm going to walk you through how to install and run a model with Ryzen AI Software. Ryzen AI Software consists of quantization tools and the Vitus AI execution provider for ONNX runtime. Developers can build and deploy machine learning models trained in PyTorch or TensorFlow and run them on select laptops powered by Ryzen AI, all made possible thanks to AMD's XDNA architecture, the first dedicated AI processing silicon on a Windows x86 processor. In the Ryzen AI workflow, the quantized model is converted into ONNX format for deployment. Using the Vitus AI ONNX execution provider, the neural network is automatically partitioned into multiple subgraphs. The subgraphs, containing operators that are supported by the IPU, also sometimes referred to as the NPU or neural processing unit, are executed on the NPU while the remaining subgraphs are executed on the CPU. This model parallel deployment technique across the CPU and NPU is fully automated and is transparent to the end user. Ryzen AI laptops enable developers to run private, on-device LLM AI workloads and concurrent applications efficiently and locally. Additionally, with a growing pre-trained model zoo on Hugging Face, support for a wide variety of models, and an easy single-click installation process, developers can get started in building their applications within minutes. To get started, we're going to install the IPU driver and the Ryzen AI software. Note that the following information is provided in our installation guide found at this link. To download the IPU driver, navigate to the following link here. This will take you to an AMD page where you can download the zip file containing the IPU driver after entering in some basic information. When the zip file finishes downloading, right-click and extract the contents. Next, open your command prompt in administrator mode by clicking Run as Administrator. Navigate to the location of the folder containing the IPU driver that you just unzipped. Enter the following command. This will confirm you want to update the IPU driver and then proceed. When it finishes, we'll check that the correct IPU driver version is installed by using the Device Manager. Under the System Devices section, double-click on AMD IPU Device, then click on the Driver tab. Here you'll see the driver version. Confirm this version matches what is included in the installation guide. Now that the driver is installed, let's install the Ryzen AI software. Before installing the Ryzen AI software, confirm that you've installed the prerequisite software shown here and that you've added the prerequisite software paths to your Windows environment variable path. Just like when we downloaded the IPU driver package, you can download the Ryzen AI software package using the link provided in the instructions guide here and entering some basic information. After it finishes downloading, right-click and extract all to unzip the folder. From your command prompt, navigate to the Ryzen AI software folder. Enter the command here. This kicks off the installer that automatically performs the following. It creates a conda environment, installs the Vitus AI ONNX quantizer, installs ONNX runtime, installs the Vitus AI execution provider, sets an environment variable to specify the 1x4 XCL bin binary, which is used for running your workloads on the IPU. It also prints the name of the conda environment before exiting the installation. Now that we've set up the development environment, let's look at how to get a model running on the AI engine. The tutorial we're going to use as a walkthrough, along with other examples, can be found at the Ryzen AI software repo on GitHub linked here. This Hello World example walks through the simple steps of porting your workload, quantizing it, and then running on hardware. Let's get started. First, we'll activate the conda environment that was created during the installation process. Then, we'll clone the Ryzen AI software repo to get access to the examples. I'm going to use VS Code to run the Jupyter Notebook, but feel free to use any IDE that you are comfortable with. There are four simple steps to getting your model running on Ryzen AI. 1. You're going to get your model and your input data. 2. You're going to export to ONNX, the Open Neural Network Exchange, which is an open standard format for representing machine learning models, making it easier to port to different hardware platforms. 3. You'll quantize your model. And 4. You'll use ONNX runtime to run on hardware. Before running the Jupyter Notebook, we want to make sure that we have all of the proper Python packages installed in our Conda environment. For this example, we've included a requirements.txt file that can be used. I'll install this from the terminal using the following command. Now that I'm set up, let's walk through the four steps, starting with getting my model. In this case, I'm creating a small model with a single linear layer as a quick demo of the workflow. Step 2 is exporting to ONNX. To export to ONNX, you provide your model, some reference input data, which can be actual data, or some random data of the same size. This is used for tracing the model. I'm providing a path for where I'd like to save the generated ONNX file. As well, I'm including the offset version, where version 13 is recommended for Ryzen AI. Now that we've exported our model to ONNX, we're going to quantize it. Quantization involves converting the AI model's parameters from floating point to lower precision representation. Vitus AI ONNX quantization provides an easy-to-use post-training quantization flow on the pre-trained model saved in ONNX format. It generates a quantized ONNX model ready to be deployed with the Ryzen AI software. I'm using the recommended settings for quantization, but for more information, see the Getting Started Guide section on the Vitus AI ONNX quantization. Now that we've got our model exported to ONNX and quantized to run on the IPU, we can now run it on hardware. To start with, I'm going to run it on the CPU so we can use that as a comparison point. To run on hardware, we're going to use ONNX runtime and create an inference session. We'll provide it the path to the quantized ONNX model file, the input data, and any inference session options we want to include. In this example, I've enabled profiling so that I can compare the CPU execution with the IPU execution. For the execution provider, I'll set it to the CPU first. I've also wrapped the execution run in a timer. Next, let's run it on the IPU. This looks very similar to the CPU run, except we'll update the execution provider to Vitus AI, and we'll provide the Vitus AI config JSON file in the provider options. Lastly, let's compare the results. There, that's your first model running on the AI engine and the Ryzen AI PC. To see more examples and continue your Ryzen AI development journey, check out the examples provided in the Ryzen AI software repo cloned earlier in this video and linked here.